Coastal Cancer. Yep, Coastal Cancer. Water levels is quite high here. Good morning. Yes, it's Beatrice and Pardet. Yes, there's Pardet. Very anxious to get onto the beach. It was raining like hell yesterday. But we are here for the morning beach walk. Beautiful, beautiful. Feather folk frolicking in the early morning. This pretty much looks like a 2.7 meter high tide surge last night. A lot of drink building up in the skies there at First Rocks. Beautiful gullies up and down the coast. Yeah, I'm now at the boardwalk entrance, also known as the Estuary Mouth Beach. Ocean is beautiful colors. Southeaster is picking up, so I doubt there's going to be much fishing happening. But nevertheless, a beautiful day on the beach. 3 days ago, Mapalon Bay was so silted up that the boat couldn't launch there. This high tide, it seems that they got to be able to launch. People keep on asking me to make more fishing videos. Guys, the morning beach walk videos is the most basic elementary videos that anyone can make. It takes me 2 hours in the morning to gather the footage and 3 hours to edit it. If I am out fishing, I'm gonna have 8 hours worth of video material to edit. That's going to take me 24 working hours of editing. I truly believe that there's enough fishing channels out there with enough funding to excite your curiosity. I'll update you about the conditions, and then you can find the videos about bait presentation traces that you can use under these conditions. Is that the deal? Because I don't think there's any sponsors out there that will spend 65,000-70,000 rand a month for me to make fishing videos about St. Lucia, Mapalon, Cape Vidal and Richards Bay. I don't think it's viable at this stage. Maybe the channel will grow in that direction. Now there's been a call for me to make a scientific video about the pros and cons of driving on the beach. Guys have asked before, I'll leave a link below. Send your video questions on WeTransfer to petrusviv@gmail.com and I will address them. I guarantee you guys that no animals was hurt in the making of this video, not even Pardet. Nee, Pardet. Ons maak nie diere seer as ons video's maak nie. Nee. Nie eers as die 4x4's en die trekkers op die strand ry nie. And it's turtle season at the moment. And you can walk this tire tracks up and down. You won't find struggling to sea turtles in the tire tracks. It's just that it doesn't happen. ready to fight and very far from your natural habitat. Yo, it's like a mile.
Peter Hornbill showing us he's behind. Doesn't want to smile for the camera. Remember the tree from this morning with the little red diker? On the way to the Gwalla Gwalla walking trail, we came past it to see if there was any squirrel nests. Is there any squirrels per day? Soek hulle vir papa. We finally arrived at Sunset Jetty, but we both did die. Me and papa.
And the Mvelazi River is still pushing in. Well, it's got nowhere else to go. If we look at where this water originates from at the break. Now I used to be able to do an estuary mouth update from here, but with the increase of the reeds, with the reeds height, it's impossible. It's roughly about there we are. Took that famous picture with the storm surge when the waves were so high. Water level update, still not the same level as last year this time, and yes, we all know the Mvelazi is still flowing in strongly, but it's not pushing this side, it's only pushing under the bridge, so the back pressure is not working in the right places. She won't drink the borehole water at home, but she'll come and drink the marsh water here on the beach. Amazing. Okay, come my dog, can you listen? Remember the phenomenon that I've been talking about on spring low tide? Here it appeared again. The suction here where the old estuary mouth used to be in the 70s and the 80s.
Sorry guys, the rain caught up with me in Pardet. So just a quick glimpse at the hippos. Please like, share and subscribe. And remember to tell your friends about what a beautiful place in Lucia Estuary is. See you on the flip side.